The anti-apartheid hero is being memorialized all across the United States, with tributes taking place throughout the Baltimore region as well. The Great Blacks and Wax Museum is planning one for this weekend at its location downtown. 11 News reporter Kim Dacey has details.
A wax figure of a young Nelson Mandela and his wife Winnie has been part of the Great Blacks and Wax Museum in East Baltimore since 1988.
We're proud of the fact that long before he was released from prison, long before the world began to embrace the struggle, Great Blacks and Wax was and saw the need to preserve his legacy.
Now that Mandela has passed away, those at the museum are reflecting on the impact he had, not just in South Africa, but around the world, fighting for freedom against a country divided by apartheid.
Nelson Mandela was a unifying force at a time when he could very well have been bitter. He fought against the apartheid system. He fought against a crippling oppression by the white ruling majority in South Africa. But he came away from that ready to unify his country and to bring peace to his country and tranquility to his country.
At 4 on Saturday, the museum will hold a memorial tribute and candlelight vigil for Nelson Mandela. There'll be speeches, singing and dancing. Anyone is welcome to attend.
We certainly, with someone of the stature of Nelson Mandela, we certainly do not want this time to pass. For me, it's simply a part of that effort that we started in 1988. To preserve his legacy.
Martin says Mandela's work had an impact here in Baltimore during the civil rights movement and the fight against segregation in this country. She says now that he's gone, it's even more vital that children learn about Nelson Mandela and his place forever in history.
Whether it's the Trail of Tears with the Native Americans, or the Long March to the Sea with Africans who were being taken to the slave forts, or whether it's segregation versus apartheid, that our children make those kinds of global connections, those kind of cultural connections, those kind of people connections with history.
They hope to create a more extensive exhibit on Nelson Mandela with an expansion of the museum in the next few years. In East Baltimore, Kim Dacey, WBAL-TV 11 News.